due to this a particular webinar or a series of the webinars. In this webinar, we have near about the more than 250 candidates who have registered, because the Google Meet have a capacity of the 250. So we have certain the 250 here candidates, and in parallel we have developed another here the classroom, that is a dummy classroom, in which the additional participants can attend or can hear the lecture, and also they can participate in the pre and the post quizzes here. Sir, in the organizing committee, we have divided the work for the purpose of the management, like the here the platform management, certificate distribution, and the here the different type of the works which have been assigned to different faculty members of the our departments. So, sir, this is the a brief about our program which we have designed. Now, again, with the prayer of the Almighty, I again welcome you, sir, and I request you for your blessing, sir, and directions, so that we can move in the decided direction, sir. Sir, Professor N. V. Singh, sir, we request you for your blessing, sir.
Professor Krishnaraj, participants from SBTU and various institutions, MATLAB team, and other people, those who are associated with organization of series of this webinar. It's really a wonderful initiative regarding teaching and learning. As we all know that we are passing through COVID-19 pandemic, and we have to adopt and follow a new normal of teaching learning as well as social distancing. Here, the whole globe is following this mode of the things, and this is a really wonderful initiative from Department of Electronics, that how various tools of the MATLAB can be used efficiently, optimally. Then before using those tools, I have observed in recent years that people, those who have this versatile software with them, but most of them are not well versed with the application of this tool. Very few people have good command on utilization of MATLAB. Although it is like ocean, where lakhs problems can be solved, and mostly related to engineering and technology. I hope that this type of programs will enhance the knowledge, application of versatile tools like MATLAB. Parallelly, some other sessions are going to be organized by different departments of the SBTU Kanpur. Previously, we have organized, and fortunately, this the first program which was organized by SPIU was inaugurated by me. Some of the listeners here associated might have heard very few words. I don't want to consume, because this is a time bound program where all the listeners, those who are associated here, want to hear experts just to enhance their learning ability, their quality of utilization. So I would just simply congratulate you all, that you all should learn it and come with a new enthusiasm, that how more and more you can do in this situation of pandemic, so I can enhance our teaching and learning processes online. Thank you all being here with us. And I once again congratulate the organizers for arranging such a wonderful webinar series. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of the department and also on the behalf of the university, I would like to pay thanks to our honorable professor, vice chancellor, sir, Professor N.V. Singh, sir, who is really a real motivator, who used to trigger us to organize such type of the programs time to time. Whatever is the requirement, that is discussed by the our vice chancellor, sir, and then we plan in order to execute those ideas. And this is also one triggering that was given by our honorable vice chancellor, sir. He always used to say, we should organize such a program that is a type of the training. We can start from the zero level. Sir, in the same manner, he had tried to design the program, and I will start it from very basic level, that is from the zero level. As you have told, sir, really MATLAB is a like the very large ocean, and it has a very long fields. All the fields are included in this one, and there are the .m file like for the purpose of the program, toolboxes are the model like the Simulink, and we will cover here the overview in this first series of the webinars. And if the participants are interested, really we will move for the another series. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your motivational and informative here the speech, sir. Thank you. So thank you very much. After this series, after this inauguration, there will be a quiz, that is the pre-quiz, in order to assess the level of our participants. So, and there are the 30 questions in the pre-quiz, and these 30 questions have to be solved within the 20 minutes. All participants are requested to participate actively for this quiz, and it is not for the any to pass or fail the any examination. It is to analyze ourselves. Ourself means to analyze the system. In the system, you and me both are the part of the system. Here, first of all, we will analyze that here the what is the level of our class teaching learning, and then we will start accordingly. And after the class, we will again analyze what is the level of the enhancement. So it is my submission, it is my request, and it is my suggestion that sincerely please appear in the quiz. And after the quiz, here the 20 minutes will be given for the quiz. It will start at 1:20. And if there any doubt or any confusion, you can ask for it. There are the 30 questions. Again, I am repeating it. For the 20 minutes, and these are the multiple choice based questions, MCQ questions related to the MATLAB. As we know, MATLAB is the applicative language, and it is used for the purpose of the programming in order to analyze a field of the application of the engineering using the toolboxes, or in order to analyze any model based on the Simulink. In this quiz, we have included very simple questions which starts from the zero level, and we will also start our discussion from very beginning, that is very zero level. There is no need of any prerequisite. The prerequisite is only the curiosity. So again I am repeating this one. There may be the candidates, there may be the participants who know much more about the MATLAB. They all are requested to support the system so that we can move all together. So first we will take the quiz, and now I request Mr. Parth Sahaji. Are you listening me? Parth Sahaji?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I think it is 1:13. So now you can launch the quiz.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, the lecture will be started just after 20 minutes, that is at 1:30 we will start the lecture, and in parallel the participants and the candidates may go through their quizzes here.
Okay, sir. I will release the quiz now.
The quiz link will be available in the chat box option of the Google Meet app. Yes, your quiz link is available in the chat box option.
The quiz has been released in the chat box. Everybody can check in the chat box and click on the link for the free webinar quiz. The link for the quiz has also been provided in the WhatsApp group created for the webinar.
आपको प्रेजेंट करना पड़ेगा कर दिया कर दिया अच्छा
All the participants are requested to not touch the present now option. Pressing this one, please beware that the presenting your desktop or mobile will interrupt the webinar. So please don't press the present now button of this app.
Okay.
Hello, everybody. Whether I'm audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So there is an announcement that in parallel, I would like to start the session, and you have to submit the quiz by the 1:36. Na.
1:35. Yeah. Yes.
1:35. Okay. 1:35. So 1:35, responses will be closed. And meanwhile, we will start the session here. Okay, good afternoon, everybody. As we know, we are here to discuss about the concept of the MATLAB. In the first slide, I would like to discuss why there is a need of such type of the language. As we have discussed in the inauguration session, that being an engineer, it's our duty to utilize the rules and regulations given by the mathematicians and scientists, either to design the new system or to maintain and enhance the existing system for the welfare of the society. And as we know, when we say the system is nothing but that one is a collection of the parts that works on a given input or the signal in order to get the desired output. And sometimes we say there is no need of any feedback, that is the system operates on the input and we can get here the desired output. But in some cases, there is need of the auto-regression, and for that purpose, a feedback is required here. Now, as we know, in order to maintain the performance of the system and time to time, the effectiveness of the system is required. When we say effectiveness is nothing but that is a function that depends upon the human skills, software, and the hardware. When we define any system, or when we are interested in order to design any system, first of all, we look into the matter of the requirements. Requirements are nothing but they are the ideal conditions. So in order to design any system, first of all, we will apply here the practical approaches in order to get the some constraints. Those are known as the specifications or determination of the parameters. And if we have decided here the parameters, then we have to decide which type of the system has to be designed, whether it is the static or the dynamic. Okay, so in order to decide here the system, that is whether it is the dynamic or the static system. If the system is static, it means there is no memory, there is no need of the memory. And if we are interested for the dynamic system, then there is a need of the memory. In order to, yeah, it's okay. So, in order to design the system, here the dynamic system, as we have discussed, the dynamic system has the memories. And now again, we will compare the performance of the two types of the system. One is the static, the second one is the dynamic. When we say static without any memory, those systems are represented with the help of the polynomials. And if the system is dynamic, means memory is required. And for the purpose of the memory, either we can use here the capacitor or we can use here the flip-flop, means the systems can be designed in either in the analog domain or in the digital domain. When we are in the analog domain and we are interested to develop the mathematical model, then that model is developed with the help of the differential equation. And when we are interested for the digital system, then that model becomes the set of that differential equation, or that may be a simple differential equation here. So after getting these equations, that is the differential and difference, we can say it is a model of the system that may be very simple, that may be very complex, and in between these two extremes here. Now, if we are interested for the difference type of the equation, that is the digital system, then difference equation is represented something like in this manner, having the yn minus k and xn minus k, where the xn is the input, xn means that is the discrete time input, yn is the output, and after processing, you will get here the yn as the function of the two, having the two terms here, the one is the negative one and the second one is the positive term here. This is only due to the input and this is due to the feedback here. Now, if we are interested for the analog system, then that can be represented with the help of the here the differential equation that may be one-dimensional or the two-dimensional depending upon the situation or the requirement. Again, if we see here the mathematical model of the system, whether we are in the digital domain or if we are in the analog domain, then we will find it is nothing but this is a function of the operators, coefficients, and the signals, that is the present and the previous signal. Here are some past outputs also here. Now, if main role of the coefficients starts here, coefficients are nothing but they are the parameters which decide the performance of our system. Now, if these coefficients are fixed, that is they are not changing with respect to time, then that type of the system is known as the LTI system, linear time invariant system. And if there is a need that the parameters are changing their values, means adaptive nature has to be adopted here, then that type of the system is named as the adaptive system. And the first one is known as the deterministic approach, and the second one is the stochastic approach here. Now, whatever is the type of the system, whether it is the LTI or it is the adaptive one, if we see, the both can be modeled by this type of the equation here. And if there is only the second term, this one, then that is known as the moving average, because it is nothing but it is like the summation of the sum values and multiplied by the sum coefficient. Like the example, if we have the three values 1, 2, 3 and we add them, then we can say 1 + 2 + 3 like the summation and divided by 3, it is a coefficient here. But in the ARS, the coefficient is fixed 1/3, but here the coefficient is changing, that's why it is also known as the moving average. And there is an autoregression, that is whatever is the output that will be given as the input to the system. That's why this model, that is if we consider both the terms here, that is known as the autoregressive model. And in total, we can say it is the ARMA model, autoregressive moving average model. Now, suppose this is a system and it is subjected to any impulse input, means it is excited by the impulse input here, then what will happen? If there is no feedback, that is the only second terms exist here, then we will get here the some response, a settled response after certain duration. That's why it is known as the finite impulse response system. But in the second case, whatever is the response, that will be again considered as the input to the system, and the response will be settled by and it will take infinite time. So this is known as the infinite impulse response system. These are the some abbreviated terms here used for the moving average, autoregressive, IIR, infinite impulse response, FIR system. So this is the background about the system. So whatever is our field, whether we belong to the mechanical engineering, civil engineering, chemical engineering, whatever is our field, first of all, we have to develop the mathematical model, and then we have to decide the type of the system, whether that one is the deterministic or the adaptive one. And again, we have to consider whether is there any need of the feedback or not. So after the decision of this mathematical model, there is a need of the analysis. And analysis must be done in both the domain, time domain as well as frequency domain. As we know, if the equations are the differential equation, that is we are in the analog domain, then for that purpose we use the Laplace transform, and equations are differential equation, then for that purpose we use the Z transform. And in the Laplace transform, when we apply the Laplace transform, it means that equation or that model becomes a function of the S, and in the Z transformation it becomes a function of the Z. And if we replace S by e to power j omega or Z by e to power j omega, and we neglect here the real portion because that is responsible only for the damping here, then we can say it is nothing but that represents here the frequency domain representation and named as the Fourier transformation. If this Fourier transformation is applied for the discrete type of the signal, then that is known as the DTFT. But when we apply Fourier transformation as an algorithm or as a system to the discrete signal, then what happens? Whatever is the output that has a function of the e to power j, something like that, at that nature of that function is the continuous. And if we are interested to process it digitally, then it is there is a requirement of the conversion of this information into the digital. So again, if the DTFT is sampled, that is the sampling is applied here, again discretization is applied to the DTFT, then this DTFT will be converted in the form of the DFT. Now again, the DFT has the function having the e to power j, k, like omega, like that, where the j and where the j and k both are the integers starting from 1 to n minus 1, for the capital N will be the interval of the discrete time signal here. Then we will see that this function, that is named as the Tudor function, it has a nature of the periodicity and the symmetricity. And if we see here the complexity of our model, then it has that three types of the operator, One is the multiplication, the second one is the addition, here the addition, and the third one is the delay that is related to the memory devices or the storage devices here. So in order to reduce the complexity, we can reduce the here the number of the multiplication and addition by exploiting the property of the symmetricity and the periodicity. Hence, we can reduce the number of the addition and multiplication. And now our algorithm, whatever is the related to the DFT, becomes fast. That's why it is known as the fast Fourier transformation. We are well aware with these type of the transformation. But whatever are the these type of the Fourier transformation, they are suitable only for the stationary signal, not suitable for the non-stationary signal like the speech we are discussing here. Because in the speech, what happens, there are so many range of the frequencies, but it is suitable only for a particular range of the particular value of the frequency. So it is not suitable for a range of the frequency. For that purpose, we use here the short time Fourier transformation, that is whatever is that time duration that is broken into the smaller time interval, and then we apply here that Fourier transformation that is known as the STFT. Again, for that duration, it becomes the stationary. So for another purpose, we use here the WT, that is wavelet transformation, that use the scaling as well as the transformation. In this one, we can see the performance of any particular range of the frequency at a particular time. So these are the concepts which are used for the purpose of the analysis. And after analysis, we utilize here the approximations. And after the approximation, whatever is our algorithm that is analyzed, and if we are getting here the satisfactory algorithm, that is the result and after analysis is satisfactory, then we will move to the next point here. Till now, we have converted the information from the requirement, that is the ideal domain, to our mathematical domain, and then approximation, etc. But in this one, we have assumed that whatever is the information from one domain, it can be transformed into the another domain, but it's not true. Because the finite precision will take place here. For example, if we are interested in order to implement our algorithm on a particular processor, then word length of that processor will affect the performance of our system. Means here the coefficient as well as the signal, both will be stored or quantized according to the here the word length of that processor. So the quantization error takes place, and after quantization, again analysis is required here. And again, if we are getting here the satisfactory result, then for the purpose of the implementation may be either of the way, that is the software or the hardware implementation. For the purpose of the software implementation, we can write the here the code. And for the hardware implementation, we can write the code, and that code can be downloaded on a given target. And then that target will be subjected to a real-time signal, and we will see here the performance of the our design, develop, downloaded algorithm on a given target. So these are the concepts we use in any branch of the engineering. Means first we think, and that thing, that idea is converted into mathematical model. It is analyzed, and then it is implemented either in the form hardware form or in the software form. Now the question arises: for these type of the analysis, these type of the mathematical modeling, similar here that these type of the different types of the approximation, quantization, there is a lot number of the equations and having a very large complexity. And in order to solve these problems, these complexity, we have to use such type of the language which is very easy for us. That is having the facility of the graphical user interface. That must be very interactive. That must be a computational language. And all the features are with the this lab here, that is the MATLAB, Matrix Laboratory. That's why we have here to discuss about the concept of the MATLAB. In this one, what we are doing, we are just developing here the theoretical concept and the mathematical model, etc. here. And we have discussed in this one in the previous slide. But here I would like to discuss this concept here. During the quantization, what happens? If we see the previous equation, then in the previous equation, the system means algorithm or the set of the algorithms, or that is the equation or the set of the equations, operates on the input signal, and then after operation we will get here the output. Now if the quantization takes place, then input will be quantized and each and every coefficients will be quantized, and accordingly output will become quantized here. What is the multiplicand, that will be quantized, and product will be quantized, and sum will be also quantized here. So the quantization will take place at the different levels here. Now, how the quantization is decided and how it will be included in our program. Now, see, first we have to see what is the mode. And mode means either we have to use mode means which type of the number system has to be used. In the because whatever we are saying here, the machine will respond only the 0 and 1, binary numbers, not our the concept and here the theoretical ideas. It will respond only the 0 and 1. So during the time of the conversion of the our concept in the 0 and 1, we have to utilize the quantization concept. And during the quantization, we have to decide the number system, whether that is the fixed point number system, floating point number system. And even if the floating point number system, then float when we write only float, it means it is user defined. And there is a standard that is known as the IEEE 754 standard, having the two types of the precision. One is a single precision having the 32-bit word length, and the second one is the double precision having the 64-bit word length. And the here the if we consider this here the mode, it means which type of the number system has to be used, then next step is the round mode, which type of the rounding has to be applied here, means whether ceiling that is towards the plus infinity, are the convergent, fixed, floor towards the negative, minus infinity, etc. Here round, there are the five modes of the approximation or the truncation which has to be used here during the time of the quantization. And due to this quantization, overflow or the underflow will take place, and we have to also take the care of this overflow, and we have to decide the mode of the overflow, whether that one is the saturation one or the ramp one. And we have to decide the data format, that is what is the total word length, capital N and small n. This is the format for the fixed point number system, that is the total word length of the of that system, and small n is the number of the bits that will be utilized to represent the here the integers here. Similarly, here the total word length and E will represent the number of the bits that will represent the exponents of the floating point number system. So we have discussed in this one that as we have discussed in the previous slide, that first we will understand the problem, then we will design the algorithm implement table that will be converted into the implement table form, and then efficient algorithm will be designed, and through the IDE, and particularly here we are using the CCS Core Composer Studio. It is nothing but this is the IDE integrated development environment. These are the steps which will be used in order to design our algorithm, and that algorithm has to be downloaded on a given target. Here suppose this is a particular processor having the interface, different type of the interfaces, so that we can interact with the real world, and we are interested to download our this concept on this given target here, and for that purpose we will use here the IDE. Now for example, say this IDE accept only the .c file, so if we have written any program, either it is the .m, .mdl, or this is written with the help of the toolbox, we have developed it with the help of the toolbox, then first of all that will be converted into the .c using the real-time workshop. So this is just describes the concept, what we have to do. First we have to develop the implementable algorithm, then that with the help of the ID that will be downloaded to the given target, and then here we will apply here the real life signal, and we will see the response of that system, means how our algorithm is working. When we download our concept on a given processor, so whatever are the here the resources of that processor, they are arranged according to our algorithm here. So this is the having the flexible connectivity, and that will be programmed as per our algorithm here. This is the concept. That's why we are moving towards a language that is known as the here the MATLAB. As we have discussed, the advantages of the MATLAB, easy to program, similar to other languages such as the C, highly integrated with the better expansion capability, and powerful numerical methods for various math problems, symbolic computation, and here the numerous toolboxes in different math engineering and non-engineering fields, powerful dynamic system simulation that can be used with the help of the MATLAB, graphical user interface based simulating modeling here, and powerful language in automatic control that can be used in the automatic control system here. And as we know, in daily life, we can use the MATLAB for the purpose of the automobiles, in the field of the communication, in the field of the aerospace, data analysis, finance, etc. There are the engineering or the non-engineering fields where we can use the MATLAB here. And in today's lecture, All participants are requested again. I am requesting with you that we have to learn here something. I will learn from yourself, and you try to be connected with me. I will try to deliver each and everything, starting from the very basic level, that is from very beginning, that is the zero here. And we will, in this lecture, we will discuss the different type of the commands, and we will see how the one word, that is one command, is capable to perform a particular type of the performance here, that may be said like a particular type of the program here. Now, for the purpose of the installing, you can use here the compiler, and either you can see here the MathsWorks website, or you can mail to the MathsWorks on this email here. And now see, if we see the construction of the MATLAB, then its main kernel is the C kernel, and with the help of these C kernels, we use the commands, and with the help of the commands, we write a program that is named as the .m file. And for a particular field of the application, we use the toolboxes like in the signal processing, control system engineering, and the next one is the Simulink. Simulink describes a model of a system. That is, if we have this designed any model, then that model will be discussed with the help of the Simulink here. When we will click the icon of this MATLAB, then we will find here the three main windows, that is the command window, workspace, and the command history here. And in the command window, we have to type the command. And now see here, this is the here the on your monitor, you will see this type of the dialog box when you will click on a icon of the MATLAB. And here, philosophy of the data storage, as we know, these are the philosophy, that is the numerical values, either in the form of the integers, floating points, complex, character strings, or that may be a structure here, or that may be cells here, Boolean form, that is the logical operation, true and false. And we will discuss here the, now we are just starting here the commands. See, nothing is special. I'm again repeating, nothing is special during the time of the learning of the commands or the program of the MATLAB. Whatever we use in our daily life, the same has to be used in the programming also. Here, see, assignment will be given by this symbol, as we used to use this one here. X is the variable that is assigned by one here, the Y is this one. And after assigning addition, we will use this one, and the Z is a net new vector that has that will depend upon the X and Y. And after addition, we will get the value of that function Z here. And similarly for the subtraction here. And now if we are interested for the multiplication, these are all related to the scalar quantities. I'm repeating it for the scalar quantities, because X has the value of the one, Y has that this one. And if for the purpose of the multiplication, whatever is the value of the Y, that will be multiplied by the 2, and hence we will get a new value of the Z here. Similarly, for the division, we will use the backslash here. For the power, we will use this cap sign here. And 5 to the power 3, that is the 125, will be written here. And now, if we again see some scalar additions here, this is the same. X is the value given value in the previous slide. And addition of the 2, we will get here the new vector Z. Here, if we are interested in order to write any matrix, then any row will be terminated by the semicolon, and elements of a particular row will be separated by either a space or by a character here, comma, like a character here. For the purpose of the subtraction, we use this symbol here, and similarly for the multiplication, again we will use the same symbol here. Now for the division, same. Now here, for the purpose of the summation, when we are interested to sum all the elements of a particular vector, then we use this summation of the xi are the elements of the vector X, starting from 1 to n, and this can be done only by writing the sum of the X. Means first we have to define the X. X is a row vector, that is the 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is a row vector having the here the characters 1, 2, 3, and 4, and they are separated by the comma here. We can use here the gap space also here. So sum of the X will become here the summation of all the elements, and we will get here the 10. Similarly, in order to get the product of the elements, and during the time of the getting the product, we will use here the column matrix. That is the one semicolon, that is the next row we will start here, two semicolon, next row, and so on. So, and if we write here the product of the Y, the here the elements, all the elements will be multiplied and the product will be displayed here as the 24. Now, if we again see here the inner product, that is the, if we say this is the row and this is a column, and if we multiply then element wise operation, that the first will be multiplied by this first one, x1 y1 plus x2 y2, like that. Here the summation of the xi yi, this is the mathematical representation of the inner product, and same can be done with the help of this one here, that first we will define the two vectors x and y, and we will put here the multiplication sign, that is asterisk. And one thing has to be noted here, that the row and column both must have the same number of the elements, as we know. So here we will get here the x multiplied by y, and we will get here the net result here. That is the summation of all the products here. And finally, we will get here the 14 as the output here. Similarly, if we are interested in order to transpose any matrix, then we just consider here the matrix and we write here the transpose of the matrix. And we know the long procedure has to be adopted in order to get the transpose of the matrix. But in MATLAB, first define the vector x and then write here the x from here, and we will get here the transpose of that matrix. That is, the rows will be changed into the column like that. Cross product, that is the vector product here. The two vectors are the x and y are given here. And if we are interested to get the cross product, then we have to just put here the cross. Nothing is special. Whatever we use, the same has to be utilized here. The same concept, same word has to be used here. So here the very basic concepts have to be adapted here. And now we are moving to a new concept, that is the vector operators here. Now in the vector operators, if we have the two vectors x and y, for the purpose of the addition, we will use the same sign x plus y, and we will get the result. And similarly for the subtraction, multiplication. Now one thing has to be noted here. Suppose we have the two vectors, then during the time of the multiplication, we can use the dot and then operator. And here the we will get here the result, that is the element wise of multiplication will take place, and we will get here the error matrix. Similarly for the division, we will use the dot and then black slice, and for the power dot and here the cap sign. Now suppose we are interested in order to display any matrix having a row matrix, then it can be represented, V is a vector that has a row elements 1, 2, 4, 5, and here this is the value here. This can be entered in the MATLAB like in this manner, that is the characters will be here they separated by a comma, or one space may be also utilized here, and this is a row vector here. Similarly, if we are interested for a column matrix, in order to represent the column matrix here, then we can use here the semicolon. That is, the first row terminates, second row starts, again terminates, and like that. And this will be the represented here, the column matrix here. Now, if we are interested for the two-dimensional array, that is the rows and columns, suppose this matrix has to be entered, then for the purpose of the entry of this matrix, or to represent this type of the matrix, we will write here the first row, that is the 1, 2, 3, and then terminate this one, semicolon, and it starts the new row and the last one. So these are the representation of the matrices. And if we are interested in order to indexing the matrix here, say if we write here the A, 2, 3 means second row, third column. So this is the second row and the third column. So the element 6 will be selected here. Similarly, if we write here that A, 2, 3, that is the second and the third row. So this is the second row and this is the third row. First and second column. So the first column and the second column. So the common elements will be the 4, minus 5, 5 and 6. This will be the index here. Similarly, and one more thing has to be noted here, that the ordering of the indices is important here. And MATLAB is also case sensitive. So here, if we write here the B, a new vector, say B, and here we have changed the here the ordering, that is the 3, 2 and 2, 1, then we will get here the different result here. Now, indexing a particular row, A1, then column, that is the first row will be selected, 1 and 2, both rows will be selected here, and same can be represented here by this command also here. If we are interested in order to represent any matrix, suppose the first element is 1 and the last element is 5, then if we write this type of the command, that is 1:5, means here the gap of the 1, by default the gap up will be considered 1. Now if we are interested to write the same values, that is 1 to 5, but having a gap of the 2, then we will write it the 1:2, last value, that is the initial value, colon, the step size, colon, then the final value. And here we see that the two vectors, both are starting from 1 and the last one is 5, but this is by default having a gap of the 1, and this has a gap of the 2, which we have selected. So we can select if a gap of the gap between the two consecutive elements here. Similarly, as we have discussed the previous commands, suppose we are interested in order to get the mean of any vector, just write here the mean of A. The result will return in the mean of A. For example, we have considered this one here. And C max of A, this will here return the largest element of the vector A. And if we write that D comma N in parenthesis, here maximum of A, means the D is the largest element and N is the position. Here if we see, then we will find what is the largest value and what is the position. For example, here the 9 is the largest value and its position is the 2. So, and for the sum of A, we have discussed this one, all the elements will be summed here. Sort of A, arrange the elements in ascending order. Similarly, the median of the A, this will return the median value of the vector. Very simple. Whatever we use, the same can be here written during the time of the writing of the program as a command. Standard deviation, STDA. Determinant, DET. Inverse of any vector or the matrix, A. Inverse of I and V. And dot product, DOT of the two vectors, and cross product of the two vectors by the cross here. There is one more thing during the time of the designing that we had to introduce some random numbers here, like the noise or unwanted disturbances. And these noise or unwanted disturbances are modeled with the help of the random number. So in order to generate the random number, we have to use these commands here. If we write here the R, A, and D, it will generate the single random number between the 0 and 1. And if we write the random in parenthesis 1, comma N, means it will generate the N numbers, random numbers, and having the values up between the 0 and 1, and this will be a row vector here. This is the example here. If we write here the random of the N, that will generate the N cross N, here the matrix, N cross N matrix will be generated here, and numbers will be naturally between the 0 and 1. And if we write the random M N, it means the M cross N matrix will be generated here. And this is the example here of the 2 cross 4. And if we write the random per N, it will generate a row vector with N elements that are permutations of integers 1 through N. If we write here the rand N, now see here that there are the two commands, one with the parenthesis and without parenthesis. If we write here the with the parenthesis, then N cross N matrix will be generated. And if we write here this rand N, that generates normally distributed numbers with means of 0 and standard deviation of the 1. That is very useful in the communication in order to modeling the concept of the noise. As we have discussed that the numerical values may be represented with the help of the floating point having the single and the double precision. And in the integer and during the time of the decision, whether we have to use the single precision or the double precision, we can write here the single or the double as in the command. Similarly, for the integers, we can write here the UINT, that is the unsigned integer having the word length of the 8 bit. Unsigned in and similarly we write here the integer, that is the here the signed integer have the 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit, and unsigned integer 16 bit and the 32 bit. These are the very simple command. Nothing is special, nothing is complex. We know each and everything. Suppose we have the each and every connection, we have to just put on our switch here. Logical of variables, the ending of the A and B. Oring of the that is the here, as we know, ending is represented by this one or in any one of these two information, not of just inverse of this one, and X R in, that is the X R command. Whatever is the name, same will be used in the command also here. And again, for the purpose of the truncation, we can use the different type of the operation here. For the flooring, we will write here the floor of this one, ceiling, rounding, fixing, rest. Here, this is the this is the remainder after the division, REM, and this is the returns to the, this one is the GCD, and this is the LCM, factorization, and whether it is prime number or not. For these purposes, we just use here the command, that is the ceiling for seal, rounding, fixing, whatever is the type of the rounding or the truncation, accordingly we will use here the command here. Now we are moving to the order of the precedences. Now the first order is the parenthesis, second is the exponentiation, the third is the logical not, fourth is the multiplication and the division having the same precedence, fifth one is the addition and subtraction, sixth is the relational operators, and the seventh one is the logical AND, and eighth one is the logical OR. And so far we have discussed the basic concepts about the numerical values, but during the time of the analysis there is a need of the graphical representation, means whatever we have done in the calculative manner, means in numerical form or the number form, the same has to be represented graphically so that we can analyze it more easy way. So now we are moving to the new domain, having the two dimensional representation and the three dimensional representation using the MATLAB. Now for the two dimensional representation, we use the command here. Just remember, only very simple plot, nothing is itself plot. For the purpose of the plotting of any graph between the two vectors, we have to use only the plot. And if we are interested to plot a function versus its independent variable, that is a function of time, then f versus t, then we have to use the f plot here. Now see the different types of the function, like the polar plot and the mesh plot and the simple plot here. And sometimes there is a need of the editing of the plot. So during the time of the editing, we have to introduce here the plot title, y-axis label, x-axis label, data type, data symbol, and some content has to be written at a particular location, at that may be the movable, and there must be the legend, tick marks on the x-axis and the y-axis. So for these purposes, we can use here the different types of the commands in the program. Now suppose we use here the plot x comma y. The two vectors are given, x and y. First we will define the x, that is the independent variable or the set of the variables, and y that depends upon the x. Now see here, if we say we are considering this table, this is the example, x is given 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 7.5, 8, and 10, and corresponding values of the y is this one here. We are interested to drive a graph between the x and y. We just use here the x plot x and y. We are doing nothing here, but just we are putting here the plot. See, we have defined the x. X is nothing but that is the row matrix. We have we can use here the comma, or we can use here the character gap. And similarly, we have defined here the y, and we have written the plot x comma y. And after putting the plot x comma y, by default we will get a solid curve between the x and y. I am repeating, by default we will get here the solid curve between the x and y, and having blue in color. No marks will be there. Now suppose we are interested again for the plot, but at this time we are interested to plot, to draw the plot having a different color, style, and marker. So for that purpose, we have to use the line specifiers. That is the plot x comma y command, same command, but in the simple inverted comma here, we have to specify the line specifiers. So what is the line specifiers? We have to decide the color, line style, and we have to decide the marker. So here for the purpose of the solid line, we put here this one dash, dotted line, dashed line, and dashed dot line. These are the style, line style. And line color, red will be represented by the R, green, this is the blue, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. These are the letters which will be used for the different colors here. Similarly, for the marker types, the different types of the markers can be used here. The plus sign, circle, asterisk, point, square, and the diamond for the different values here. Now see here, if we write here the plot x comma y, then by default we will get here the solid line blue in color. Plot x comma y, that will be a solid line, but the color will be red. Plot x comma y, here the dashed line will be represented in yellow color, and here the plot x comma y asterisk will be used as a marker, then plot x comma y, that is the graph between the x and y, green in color, and the points here the will be used for the marker here, dotted points, and the here the d, that is the mark here, the we are using here the green in color, and D is the diamond markers will be used here. Now see, a table is given. Now it is nothing but this is the x vector, this is the y vector, and we define the x vector and the y vector. Since there is a consecutive gap of the one, that's why we have given here the initial value is the first one, is the this is the last value. So by default it will take a gap of the one, or we can write here the gap of the one. Cells are this one. So plot x versus y, and line specifiers here the dashed line, red in color, and asterisk in sign. So now see the result here. We are using red in color, dashed line style, asterisk in color here. Similarly, if we are interested in order to draw the plot for a function, then suppose the function is 3.5, its power minus 0.5x. cos 6x, for the value of the x minus 4, 2 to 4. One thing has to be noted here, that whatever are the example here we are taking, these are related to the static system. They are not dynamic system. They may be the linear or the non-linear. For example, this is the non-linear function, but they are not the dynamic system, because the dynamic system must be represented either using the differential equation or the difference equation, which we have discussed in the very first slide of this discussion here. So here the part, in order to write the comment, we will use here the percentage sign. These are the comments here. These are not the parts of our program. We will just define here the x. X has a range minus 2 to 4 here. We have defined minus 2 to 4. And if the gap is given, then we will define here the gap. Otherwise, we can select this gap as per our need and the requirement. And y, this is the y, is the function. We will define the y, that is the 3.5, its power. Here we are using the power. Just remember one thing, that is the, we are using the dot then operator, because vector is this one here. And then minus 0.5x cos 6x. Now plot x comma y. So naturally we will get here the a graph between the this function having the exponential, cosine, between the x here. Now see this one here. Now if we reduce the gap between the two consecutive values here, suppose now the gap is from 0.01 to 0.3 here. Same function, nothing is different, but the gap is reduced here. So we will get here this type of the curve. So if the gap is smaller and smaller, we will get, we will here the receive better and better performance, are the better and better function, that is more smooth function. Now if we are interested to draw the f plot, and at the same time we are also interested to define the range on the x axis and y axis, then we will use the command f plot function and then limits. Now see here, just writing one word of the command, we are in position to get the responses here. So here f, if we write here the f plot and then define the function, comma, limits. And limits are nothing but the limits on the x-axis, that is the minimum value of the x to the maximum value, or x-axis as well as the y-axis, both will be defined here. Now see, this is the function. Suppose the function is given as y is equal to x square plus 4 sine 2x minus 1, and the range of the x is minus 3 to 3. Then we write here the f plot and define the function, function itself, and then in the bracket we have to define the range of the x, we will get here the graph. between the function and the range of the x. From in previous one, if we see, then we will find that range is from minus 3 to 3 here. Now, suppose we are interested to plot the multiple graphs in the same plot here. Then for that purpose, we will use the plot command, and then we will use the hold on and the hold off commands. This type of the plots are required during the time of the analysis, comparative analysis of the performance of the different system or the different types of the equation or the different types of the model. So for that purpose, we can very simple command. We can use the, suppose that here the y depends upon the x, v depends upon the y, s depends upon the t. Then we just write here the plot x comma y, u comma v, t comma s, and we will get the three graph in the same plot here. Now say we are but these three graphs will have the same color, solid line having the blue color. So in order to differentiate them, we can put here the line specifiers, that is the x comma y dash, that is the solid line blue in color, and u comma b, this is the red in color, and this is the here the green in color. Now we can use these commands in this example here. Suppose y is given by this equation having the range of the x minus 2 to 4 here. We define x and we will define y. And then suppose yd is not a command, it is a symbol, a symbolic representation of the, here we have written this one is the yd, is the yd represents the first derivative of the y. And when we derivate this one, then we will get here the first derivative of this one will become this one here, and second derivative is this one. Now suppose we are interested to plot the graph between the x and y, x and first derivative and x and the second derivative here. Then we can write here the plot x comma y, and here the blue in color, x comma yd red in color, dashed line, x and the second derivative black in color. Now see the result here. We will get the three graphs in the same plot, and now we can compare the performance of these three types of the equations or the system here. The same can be done also with the help of the hold on and hold off command. First we will plot the command, and then we will write the hold on, and then after putting the different commands, when the all the commands have been over, then we will write here the hold off. For example, say the plot of the function is this one is given, the derivative and we are interested in order to draw the plot between the yd, that is the first derivative, second derivative, and here they say this is the range of the x. So first define the x, define the y. Y is nothing but that is the function of the x, and first derivative, second derivative. Now plot x comma y, that is between the x and y, and this is the blue in color. Hold on, after first plot command, hold on, then plot x comma yd red in color, plot x comma ydd black in color, and if more are required, then we will write the more commands here. And after when all the commands have been over, we will write here the hold off. Now see, this is the result here, which can be used by using the hold on and hold off command here. Now editing can be done by double clicking on a particular mark or the line here. The suppose that we are interested in order to write something on the x-axis, then by double clicking we can edit this one. Similarly y, similarly we can edit the line here, the this one is the title or any text when written, or this may be also a part of the program. So it is advisable that during the time of the writing of the program, we should consider it as a part of the program, so that when we apply here the profiling enhancement of the coding, this all the here the codes may be modified accordingly here. So here for the purpose of the adding the title, now see here the different types of the commands which will be used for the purpose of the formatting. For the title, we will just write here the title, then in the bracket, in the single inverted comma, write the string whatever is the written for the title. Then for the x label, whatever we are interested to write on the x label, the same will be written here in the string, and similarly for the y label. And now if we are interested to define the range of the axes, x and y axis, then write here the command axis, range of the x axis and the y axis here. Now legend, in order to enter the legend here, just write here the legend, then string one, that is for first one, second one and third one. Similarly, if we are interested to write something at a particular location or the position x and y, then write here the text at x comma y. And if we are interested to write something that is movable, that we are interested, no, this is not a particular location, now we are interested to move this one from this location to this that location, then that can be done with the help of the g text command here. So if we are interested for the fixed string here, fixed position, then text. Otherwise for the movable, we will use the g text here. Now, for example, if we consider that this one is the example related to the light intensity here, then we will define here the x and y and the first derivative, and plot here the f graph between the x and y, hold on x, here the first derivative of the x and y, then hold up. Now we, if we are interested to edit the graph here, this will be the graph here. But after, for the purpose of the editing, we can click here to different position in order to edit it, selecting the edit option, or we can also include it into the, using the different type of the command. One more popular graph is the logarithmic graph, semi-log graph. This is the very simple graph which we have discussed, that is the plot between the x and y. Now suppose we are interested in order to draw a graph between the x and y has very large range, then that range will be, in order to represent that range, we have to use the logarithmic scale on the y. So for that purpose, we will define the x and y, then just write here the semi-log and then that axis, which axis? Y, and then comma, x comma y. Similarly, if we are interested for the logarithmic plot on the x axis, we just write here the semi-log x, x comma y. And if both axes have to be written using the log scale here, then we will write here the log, then in parenthesis x comma y. Very simple, very useful, very attractive. Now plots with special graphics, that is the bar graph. Just define here the x axis, y axis value, that is the year and the cell, bar, year versus cell. And if there is no specifier, then we will get here the blue color. And since we have defined here the color red, that's why we will get here the bar graph. And what is the specialty? That is the vertical graph, red in color, because we have defined it. Now suppose we write the bar H and we have not defined the color, no specifier has been used here, then we will find a horizontal a bar graph, and that will be blue in color here. And suppose we are interested for the stair function, again in the similar manner, define the x and y, right, just write here the stairs x comma y, we will get here the stair function. For the discrete function, that is named as the stem function, write here the year, and so that is the x of y, put here the stem, and we will get here the stem function, that is the discrete function here. Sometimes there is a pie chart which is required during the time of the grading, etc. Here suppose in our class 11 students have the grade A, 16 B, 18 C, D and E. So we will write here the first vector, that is the grade, having the total number of the students having the A grade, B grade, C grade, and then write here the pi and then that vector grade. And title, we can insert here the title, class grades, our particular name of that class, and we can introduce here. And if we are interested for the polar plot here, for as we know, polar plot utilizes in during the time of the designing of the here the antenna, etc. So here, if we are interested for the polar plot here, then we have to define the theta and the radius here. So just define here the theta and the radius. After defining theta and radius, we write here the polar, polar T and R. Right. Now if we are interested for the polar plot, then for the polar plot we again define here the theta and the radius, and right here the polar between the T and R. Now, if, here for the other purposes, if we are interested to fill the color, then we will write here the fill. First, write the T and R, and then we will define here the fill X comma Y having the red in color, and we will get here the this type of the graph here. If we are interested for the bar chart having a some little bit complex function here, then first again we will define here the theta and the radius having the very simple or very complex equation. It hardly matters what is the equation, whether that one is very simple or that one is very complex. We have to just remember, we have to define the two vectors. In the x, y, we have to define the x and y. Here we have to define the theta and the radius here. And we will get here the graph like this one. Again, this is the pie chart. And now I'm moving to the three-dimensional plots here. For the three-dimensional plots, we will use here the plot 3 command. As in the two-dimensional, we have to just use the plot. Now we have to use the plot 3. For example, say the t is the independent variable, x is defined in terms of the t, y is defined as in terms of the t, and z is also defined in terms of the t. So x, y, z, three vectors are defined as a function of the t, and range of the t is defined first, then define the x, y, z as per our need or as per the requirement, and then write here the plot 3, x, comma, y, comma, z, and here the color of the this one here. Now if we see, then we'll find this is the equation of the helix here, right? Now coming to the next one, plotting matrix data here. Now suppose matrix data Z and Y, if we write this type of the command, that is the X comma Y mesh grid, then it transforms the domain specified by the vectors, that is the X and Y, into the arrays here. The X, Y are the inputs, and capital X and capital Y are the outputs. So what will be the capital Y? Here the in this one we will transform the information of the X and Y, that is the rows will be transformed to the rows of this one, and every column of this one will be copied to the column of this one here. And if we are interested in order to plot the graph, then we just write here the plot 3XYZ, and gridding can be done by using the grid on. We will get here this type of the graph. For these are the, we have to just remember this function, that is for the surface plot we have to use the surface mesh plot mesh, and the contour plot we have to use the mesh C, surface C, mesh Z, that is the cutting plot, that is the only the Z axis will be utilized here, so this is known as the mesh Z. And P colors, it is the flat surface plot, and the value of is proportional to only colors, that is it is named as the P color here. The surf L, that is the surface plot eliminated from the specified direction here, and surface, when we write the surface, low level function on which high level functions are based for creating surface graphics object here. Now see here some more example for the mesh and the surface plot here. For the mesh plot, we have to define X and Y, then vector capital X and Y in terms of the small X and Y, then Z. And Z will be defined in terms of this output of this XY after grading, mesh grading. And here we will write the mesh. We have to use only this command, that is the mesh X comma Y Z, X level, whatever we are interested to write on the X level, Y level, we can write here. Very simple or very long word here are the letter, whatever we are interested for that one, we can write here on the X axis and the Y axis. Illustrating the use of the mesh grid. Now see here, we are getting very attractive, very complex graphs here, but by doing nothing, we are getting here everything by a very simple effort. And we can say that is not effort, but we are well aware with those concepts. Now we are just using those concepts here. One submission and one request is again here, that please go through the practice of these commands here and write each and every command. Don't try to copy and then paste on the here the command window. Write each and every command so that whatever is the error, that can be displayed. And if the error is taking place, it means at each and every time when error takes place, it teaches us. So we have to write the command on the here the command window in order to check these commands here. Similarly, if we are interested for a sync function having the nature of the sign R by R, then we will here the mesh grid of the to return the capital X and Y, and then we will define the R, and after defining the R, we will write here the command sign R by R, and here we are using the dot and then operator, and mesh X comma Y comma Z here, and we will get this type of the graph here in this one, and that is the name is the mesh grid function. Now, if we are interested for the surface three dimensional colored surface here. Now, for if we write here the surf x comma y comma z and c, c is the vector that defines the color here. Now, this command will be utilized here. Now, see, we are using here the surf x comma y comma z. Then, specification about the color means what will be the face color, intrape, edge color, different colors will be defined here, and we will get this type of the graph here. Now, surface plot that is covering the total area of the mesh. For that purpose, we will write here the surf. For the mesh, we have to use the mesh command, and for the surface plot, we have to write only the surf command here. Now, surface plot of the non-uniform sample data here. If we use here the non-uniform sample data here, for example, we have used here to generate the unevenly sample data. Then we have used the line space command, then mesh grid, and then grid the data, and then write here the command for the mesh x comma y comma z. Now see the result here. This will be the result for plotting the non-uniform sampled data. Now the curtain plot, as we have discussed that in the curtain plot, we have to consider only the z axis here. So we will consider here the mesh z command. So we will define the x and y, then capital X and capital Y by using the mesh grid command, and we will define the capital Z in terms of the capital X and Y, and then we will write here the mesh Z, and we will get here the curtain plot. Only see this one is the curtain plot. That is the only the vertical axis will be represented here, the curtain plot Z. Only if we use this command here, that is the x is defined, y is defined, and z is defined in this one. Here we are using the what is difference here? Just see very small difference. Mesh and C. That is the mesh command along with the contours here. So this is the mesh plot here, and C includes the contour plots here also here. So this is the mesh C command, and we are getting here the mesh plot as the contours. And similarly, if we are interested for the surface contour, then we can use the surf C. That is the we define the x, y, z, and then write here the surf C, and we will get here the surface and the contour plot here. Surf L in this one the is the same as the surf command, but here the surface is highlighted by a light source. So here we have defined the x, y, and z. Then we have written the surf L command, and we will get this type of the graph here. So again, this is a waterfall. As the mesh z, we have used only z axis here. If we are interested for the waterfall, that is one dimensional. So for that purpose, we will get here the waterfall x comma y comma z, and we will get this type of the graph here. If we are interested only for the contour, then we will define x, y, and z. We will use here the contour three dimensional between the x, y, z, having how many number of the contours. If we see, then there are the 15. The see that this is the middle one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 upper side, and same 7 for the lower side. So 15 contours are there. Similarly, we can use again, this is again for the contour plot, having the different function. Now for the sphere plot, we can use only the sphere command. If we are interested to draw any sphere for a particular given data, then we have to not write a very complex equation or complex program for that one. You just can do it by using only one command, that is the sphere. When we write the three vectors, that is x, y, z, sphere, n, it generates the 3n plus 1 by n plus 1 matrices, so that the surf x, y, z produces a unit sphere. And when we write the XYZ, means the N is the 20 here. So see here, we have used the sphere 20 and we have used the surf command. After generating the three matrices, we have used the surf XYZ and we will get here this type of the graph here. Now, if we are interested in order to see any particular view, top view, side view, left side or right side, in order to design a system or in order to observe the performance of any system or in order to analyze some errors or other thing, so for that purpose, we have to decide which view is required. For the top view, we will decide the azimuthal angle and the elevation angle, that is the 0 and 90. Side view, that is the XZ 0, 0 and the YZ, that is the side view 90, 0 here. So here we can decide the azimuthal and elevation angle and accordingly we can decide which view has to be seen here. For example, if we draw a graph, this one here, the mesh grid, and this is the surface plot of that graph here. And now suppose we are interested, this is the graph for the surface plot here, and if we are interested for the 180 degree view, then this will be the 180 degree view of this graph here. Now, if we use this again, this is a view and this view has the azimuthal angle 90 degree and the elevation angle the 0 degree here. Now, it is again related to the sphere. Now some special discussion means some special points which has to be considered in MATLAB, and we can consider it as a node. If we write mean square n a n, then what will happen? The function mean square returns the mean of the square of all finite value inputs. Since n a n is not finite values, so what will be the result here? The result will become zero. If we write here the mean absolute 1, 2, minus 3, then it means here the value first will be converted into the absolute value, minus 1 will be become 1. So the total value will become the 1, 2, 1, that is the total sum is the 4, mean of this absolute value divided by 3, 4 by 3, 1.33. Now if we define any vector A having the first row, these are the elements starting from 1 to 7 having a gap of the 3, that is this become the 1 4 and 7. Similarly the second row, third row, and product of a first row, that is it suggests that all the elements of the every column are to be multiplied and the result is going to be displayed as a row vector, and hence we will get here the 6 20 and 5 0 4 here. Now if we write here the product 1 n a n, since the range we have defined as 1, so each and every element will be multiplied by the 1 here. So the product of any number with n a n will give an output n a n, so the output of this one will become the n a n, not a defined number. If we write here the command cumulative sum 1, 2, 3, 4, n, then up to 1, 2, 3, 4, there is no problem. But after this one, what will happen? This is a not defined number. So 1 will be added to the previous one, 0, so that will become the 1. 1 and 2, 3, and 1, 2, and 3, 6, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. So this will be the output here. Now, output of the following code, suppose we write here a code, see here the code, and we are using here the conditional loop, that is the for I 1 to 4 and J 1 to 4, and A is defined as 5, and then next A becomes A plus 5. Now what is happening, there are the two loops, first and the second. For each and every loop, the A will be, value of the A will become 5. For starting from 1 to 4, because we have used here the semicolon, so it will not move to the next one. For each and every iteration, it will remain the 5, and hence at the last when after 4, it will move to the next step, it will become the A plus 5. So the value will become the A plus 5. that is the 5 plus 5, it becomes the 10. Now, the correct syntax of the function which performs the mean square of a set of the elements is the mean square. The correct syntax of the function which returns the square root is the square root. And if we are interested for the mean square of a set of the elements, so it will become the mean square of the parenthesis here. That is the square root of the mean square function. If A is given by this one and product of this one, similarly we can get here the result as we have discussed in the previous one. This will be multiplied by 2, and then whatever is the row column matrix, that will be converted into the row matrix, because here we are using the transpose matrix. Here we have used the first column, that is the transpose of the matrix here. The correct syntax for the function which does cumulative summation is cumulative sum. The cumulative sum of the 1, 2 and minus 2. We cannot give a negative number as the input, so here the error will take place in this type of the command. We can write omit an an, that is, if there is any number omit an, not a defined number, then we can exclude this one by using the omit an an. For example, if the a is a vector 1, 2 and this vector an, not a defined number, then in order to get the sum of the a, means all elements of the a will be summed here, but omit the not a defined number. The result of cumulative sum 1, 2, 3 is 1. Suppose we have the two command. One is the cum sum and the second one is the sum. Cum sum, cumulative sum, that is the 1 will be added to the 2, that is the 1, 3 and 6 will be the output. But here if we write only the sum 3, 3, then 3 plus 3 will be added and we will get only the 6 here. If we write this type of the command, then it represents the symbolic values of the A and K here. Since means symbolic one. The predefined function in MATLAB to view the graph of a continuous and discrete time function, as we have discussed in the plot, that is the plot related to the continuous function and stem related to the discrete function here, or the discrete plot here. If x is given from minus 10 to 10, y is from minus 10 to 10, but here if we see, then there is a gap of the 1, and in this case, there is a gap of the 2. So the number of the elements are different in the x and y. So we will not get a plot between the x and y, and hence the error will take place. If this is the command x minus 10 to 10, and minus 10 to 10 having the same gap, that is the 1, and off we then plot x comma y, we have used the axis command before the plot command. Here we have first we have defined the axis here, then we have used the plot. So here first we have defined the range of the axes, and then we have the use here the plot. So the plot has not been created before the axis, and we will see a graph having the x and y, but there will be no graph. We have to keep in mind the order while trying to plot two matrix arguments. MATLAB will take the column wise relation between the two arguments. So if x is x1, x2, x3, y1 is the y1, y2, y3, then when we write the plot x comma y, it is a plot between the x1 and y1, x2 and y2, and so on. Semi log x, we have discussed this one, that is the x axis will be logarithmic here. And after trying to plot a pie chart, suppose some students one problem has given in your queues that the students write here the rows. So in place of the pie, he has written, he or she has written the pie here. This is a predefined function in MATLAB. If we want to place a text at a position, we have to use the text, and if we are interested to write a movable text, then for that purpose we have to use the gtext command. The values of x should be increasing or decreasing in order to draw the graph here. Usually the default value of the bits is 0.8. when we draw the
bar graph, then the here the width of the bar is 0.1, and when we consider the one as a width, then all the bars are just touching to each other. And if the value of the width is more than one, then what will happen? They will overlap to each other. To plot graph of fx and is equal to t and gy as a t in the same graph with the t as a parameter, the function to be used is the plot 3xyt. This will allow to draw the three-dimensional plot, and the plot will show both the function f and g with t on the z-axis. This is the three-dimensional plot which we have discussed as the first example during the time of the discussion, very starting of the three-dimensional plot. Now suppose these are the values of the a is given as the 100, and if a is greater than 99, then clear a. Since a is greater than 99, when we write this type of the command, the clear command will be executed and we will get all the functions will be cleared here. The workspace window shows the attributes of the variables, the script files, functions from the command window, for as we have discussed in the different types of the windows here. If we write this type of the command, that is the py120111, following the syntax of the predefined function py in MATLAB, we find the length of the two arguments passed into the py, argument 1 and argument 2 here. Must be the same. But here the argument 2 has the two elements, but 3 has the second one has the three elements. So here in this case, the error will take place. Square root is the predefined function used to find a square root of large numbers to reduce the complexity of equation. So square root, this is for the symbolic purposes. It is especially used in the MATLAB workspace. So this is all about the basic concepts of the MATLAB. In the first lecture, we have discussed the need of the application of the MATLAB, why there is a need of the MATLAB. And we have also tried to discuss the different commands which will be used here in order to write the program. And after this one, I think it is the 236, and at 240, we have planned a post quiz. So we will move for the post quiz. And again, I would like to request you all people to make a practice for these commands. And very tough practice is required. We just have to write the commands on our command window. And if we are very used to these commands, then we can move for the program, that is the .m file. And if we are in position to write the program, so by arranging so many programs, we can utilize those programs for a particular field of the application, and that becomes a particular type of the toolbox. And for the purpose of the modeling, we can use the Simulink. And here we have discussed the concept of the coding using the .m, .mdl or the toolbox. But till now we are in position so that we can use the different types of the command. So thank you all. Thanks to all respected audience for patience hearing. And I would like to again request to go for the quiz so that we can analyze what is the level of the enhancement in our learning. So thank you very much. Now I'm handing over these commands to Dr. Suman Kumar Mitra, Dr. Manish Singh, and Professor Rajni Vist Madam, and Mr. Parth Saha, in order to conduct the command.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Wonderful presentation, sir, from your side. Sir,
should we go for the questionnaire round first?
Okay. Release the quiz link over the WhatsApp groups and email as soon as possible.
Okay.